Hello, this is Arielle from Inconspicuous Bear, and I'll be narrating Silver Proving Grounds for Tanks in Warlords of Draenor from a Guardian point of view. Silver isn't really that much more difficult than bronze, in all honesty. The mobs aren't particularly threatening. There are a couple that can be quite a pain to deal with, but in most cases, they're not that big of a deal. However, it is a good idea to start getting used to using your active mitigation buttons in these proving grounds, because you will definitely need them for gold and endless. The first wave starts off with one large and one small Sarok, the little mobs that we met in bronze. They're pretty trivial and extremely harmless, and Sakari will just end up killing both of them without any sort of trouble at all. All of the mechanics stay the same. Same amount of healing, same amount of damage, it's just the bombs are harder. The second wave is a bunch of rabbits. Again, what we saw in bronze. They're a little bit more dangerous than they were in bronze, so don't be afraid to use some of your active mitigation buttons for guardians in particular. This will be Savage Defense and Friends of Regeneration. Savage Defense to block the application of bleeds, and the Friends of Regen to heal from them. Tooth and Claw won't really do anything for these guys. And also, don't be afraid to use your Tier 30 and Tier 90 talents, particular Dream of Cenarius and Cenarian Ward, if you feel you get low for some reason or another. And also, you still have Barkskins, don't worry about that. So Wave 3 introduces a new kind of mob called a Flamecaller. They always start out like this, they spew lava everywhere, and then they will single target Sakari. Unless you intervene and pick them up or whatever. The thing about these mobs is that they do a lot of... they're casters, so obviously they do a lot of damage. You can straight up ignore them in silver and just let Sakari tank them and heal herself, because she has the same haunt that you do, and you taking the damage while dealing with other mobs is not really good, because it's very high burst. Now, those pools of lava that we were just talking about, what they do is they apply a stacking dot, actually, on anything that stands in them, including bad mobs. So you can see here, I positioned the rabbits in such a way that they would be caught in the fire. This means they'll die really, really fast. So these guys are dying really fast. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Again, even though this is, I think this is a large flame caller, you can do the same sort of thing and ignore it. Keeping an eye on Sakari's health is probably a good idea, just in case she gets like super low. Don't really worry about them in general. As a guardian, of course, you do have three interrupts. Three interrupt-like effects. Actually, that's a lie. Four. With Bash, Face Silence, Skull Bash, and Typhoon. So don't be afraid to make use of those. I know other tanks have less, but anything that you can do to reposition them also interrupts and so forth. Just like a bunch of other mobs, so don't worry about them. This wave starts off with a couple of Sarok, a small flame caller, and then spawns a set of rabbits afterwards. I'll simply position them in the fire, as I've done here, and they will fall over and die very quickly. Nothing particularly to worry about, because otherwise they're completely harmless. And this wave will finish off. This last guy is being kind of annoying. The fire just does dissipate after a while, so don't be afraid, or don't be surprised if it just ends up going away before where the mobs are dead. But there you go. This next wave introduces us to a new mob called a wind something. It's basically a mantid. I don't really know what else to say. Their special ability is they will basically punt you and drop aggro. This is something reminiscent of mobs back in Brockwing Lair, where this mechanic was first introduced. So they'll punt you and drop aggro. Not necessarily drop. It's a threat reduction. It's like a really high percentage threat reduction, but it's not a complete wipe. So it is entirely possible to maintain aggro after they punt you. It's just not very, very likely, especially if Sakari is the one damaging them. Alone, they're pretty harmless. If they come in groups of more than one, then they give me kind of a problem. The small ones are particularly non-threatening, but the large ones can deal a lot of damage. Here you can see I backed through the fire like an idiot, and it caused kind of a problem for me, so I had to use a cooldown. But, and the Sarok, yeah, Sarok just died. So we're just left with the Mantid and the Flamecaller. I also made the gigantic mistake of aggroing the caster. That was really dumb. I should not have done that. So I was taking a lot of damage there. And we have a caster. And he's just going to die. Because that's what casters do. Doesn't matter if they're your friends or your enemies. All the casters do is get aggro and die. And this should be our last wave, starting very shortly. And here we are introduced... Well, we start off with some Rabbids and a Mantid. This is kind of a dangerous combination. Don't be afraid to use a short duration cooldown, or a short, short-term cooldown. I like Barkskin, Divine Protection, or Glyph Divine Protection, I guess, and that sort of thing here. Also, Active Mitigation really helps for managing both the Rabbits and the Mantid, Windguard, I guess it's called. And we'll have a Sarok and a Flamecaller spawn after those come down partway through the wave. Again, just ignore the Flamecaller entirely, pretty much, because it'll just cast onto Sakari, and Sakari doesn't care. She really does not care. and then the Sister Sarok's going to die, and then we'll go kill a caster. If it really becomes a problem, like you can see, Sakari is around 30% healthier, so interrupting the Flamecaller wouldn't necessarily be a bad idea. So we interrupt it, move it forward, and get aggro on it. Unlike the DPS, DPS proving rounds, if you run out of time at the end, you don't fail. It means you need to kill the mobs. And that's how you complete Silver Tank proving rounds. Pretty simple.